Hello and welcome to Khalsa Design. Tanish Singh here. Today we have got a really cool effect to dive into. We are going to create this awesome vibrant glow animation right here in DaVinci Resolve. Let's get started. First things first, create new fit and composition. I'm going to set the frame rate to 30 FPS. Now drag that new fit and composition onto your timeline and head over to the fusion page. Okay, in fusion page, let's add a background node. Add and connect a rectangle mask to the background node. Select the rectangle mask and in the inspector panel, let's set the width to 0.6 and height to 0.45 and a corner radius to 0.45 to give it those nice rounded edges. Creating that light effect, select the first background node, change the type to gradient and then the gradient type to radial. Right click on the start to modify width and select vector result. Do the same for the end control. Head over to the modifier tab. We want to keep the points accessible. So click the little pen icon next to the start and end vector. Set the distance for the start value to 0.3 and the image aspect to 1. For the end value, set the distance to 0.2 and the image aspect to 0.1. To make the glow rotate smoothly, right click on the end angle and select expression. Link the end angle to the start angle using the plus handle. Let's animate the rotation. Go to frame number 0, set the angle value to 0 and click the letter diamond icon to add a keyframe. Now move to the very last frame and set the angle value to negative 360. On the tools tab, you can change the colors of the gradient points to get the look you want for your glow. Next, add a color corrector node after the background node. At frame 0, add a keyframe for the hue control and set X value to 0. Move to the very last frame and set the hue value to 1. Open spline window, select a keyframe for the hue and press S to smooth the keyframe. Select background node and open spline window, smooth the keyframes for angle. Finally, for the light effect, add a glow node after the color corrector. You can adjust the glow intensity, gain, and other settings in the inspector to fine-tune the look. Now let's create a border line around our glowing shape. Add a merge node, connect the glow node to the merge, add another background node, and connect it to the merge. Select the first rectangle mask we created for the glow shape, copy it, and paste it. Connect the new rectangle mask to the second background. Select the rectangle one and in the inspector, slightly increase the width to 0.605 and the height to 0.455 to create a thin outline. Select the second background node and set its color to gray tone. Let's add some shaded text. Add a text plus node and connect its output to the output of the first merge node. Select the text plus node and type your desired text in the inspector. Set the size to around 0.15. Go to the shading tab. You will see softness X and softness Y. Max out both these values to create that soft shaded look. Now drag the output of the copied rectangle mask and connect it to the mask input of the text plus node. This will confine the shaded text within the glow shape. Now for the main text, add another text plus node and connect its output to the output of the merge node. Select the second text plus node and type your main text. Set the font and type to regular. Set the size to around 0.15. Go to the shading tab and select element number 3. Enable it, set the appearance to the border fill and the level to line. Increase both extend horizontal and extend vertical values to their maximum. Choose your desired color for the border. Finally, drag the output of the copied rectangle mask and connect it to the second text plus node. In the inspector, for this text plus node, set the opacity to 0.9. Let's add a touch of 3D movement. Add our DVE node. After the merge node, go to frame number 0. Add a keyframe on the Y rotation and set its value to 90 degrees. Move to around frame number 60 and set the Y rotation back to 0. Open the spline window, select the keyframes for the Y rotation and smooth the animations. Now let's create a main background for our animation. Add another merge node, add a background node and connect it to this merge. Connect the DVE node to this new merge. Select the new background node, change the type to gradient, set the start Y value to around -0.5 and the end value to around 1.5. Select gradient point 2 and choose a dark gray color. Select gradient point 1 and adjust its position value to around 0.3. Go to frame number 60 and add a keyframe on gradient control. Go back to very first frame and change the position value of gradient point 1 to around 0.9. Open spline window, smooth the keyframe. Let's add a little bouncy scaling effect. Select the very last merge node, go to frame number 60 and add a keyframe on size value and its vector. Move to the very last frame of your composition and add another keyframe for the size. Go back to very first frame and set the size value to 0. Open the spline window, select these size keyframes and smooth them out. This will create a nice little pop. Alright, let's preview what we have created. Here you have it, a vibrant glow animation created entirely in DaVinci Resolve. If you enjoyed this tutorial and found it helpful, please hit the like button and subscribe to Khalsa Design for more DaVinci Resolve tips and tricks. Thank you so much for watching and I will see you in the next one. Thanks, bye.